Welcome to all. I am Dr. M. R. Kadam, Assistant Professor at Department of Chemistry, Balasaheb Desai College, Patan. Now we learn the second part of the colorimetry and spectrophotometry, which is most commonly used for accurate analysis. First, we learn the classification of methods used for color comparison or color measurement. In colorimetric and spectrophotometric quantitative analysis, color of unknown concentration solution is compared with the color of known concentration solution, that is standard solution. This comparison may be carried out by one of the following six methods. First, standard series method. Second, duplication method. Third, dilution method. Fourth, balancing method. Fifth, photoelectric photometer or colorimeter method. And sixth, spectrophotometer method. The last two methods are most commonly used. Now we learn the photoelectric photometer or colorimeter. This is of two types, single cell and double cell photoelectric colorimeter. The instrument used for single cell photoelectric colorimeter has five parts. First one, a light source. Second, light filters. Third, cells or cuvettes. Fourth, photoelectric cells. And fifth one is galvanometer. The first part of this instrument is light source. In this, a light lamp operated by 6 volt battery or a constant voltage transformer is used as source of incident light. Most commonly, tungsten or carbon arc lamp are used. The second part of the colorimeter is light filters. In this, optical filters, which consist colored glass or colored gelatin coated on glass. This transmits narrow wavelength range light. To select the suitable filter, absorbance or transmission wavelength calibration curve is obtained by using each filter in turn. The best filter is that which gives minimum transmission or maximum absorbance for given concentration of the colored solution. The less satisfactory method includes use that filter whose color is complementary to the color of solution. The third part of the colorimeter is cells or cuvettes. These are used as containers for solutions, which are rectangular or cylindrical vessels having accurate dimensions. For UV light, cells made from quartz are used, while in visible glass are used. The working surface of the cells should be clean, hence it is washed first with distilled water and rinsed with test solution. The fourth part of the colorimeter is photoelectric cells. These cells are also called as transducer, as they convert light energy into the electric energy. These are of three types: photoemissive cells, photoconductive cells, and photovoltaic cells. In most of the colorimeters, photovoltaic cell or barrier layer cell is used. A photovoltaic cell consists of base plate I, which is made up of iron. Upon this plate, a thin layer of selenium is deposited, which is covered with transparent gold layer. The gold layer has varnished except the collecting ring. The underside of iron plate is covered with non-oxidizing metal. When a light passing through a thin gold layer falls on the selenium surface, electrons are released. These released electrons forms hypothetical barrier layer of electrons, which offers negative charge to the gold layer. Hence, R becomes negative pole, while the iron plate positive pole. If this cell is connected to the galvanometer, current will be flow and it will vary with intensity of the light which falls on the photovoltaic cell. The advantages of photovoltaic cells are: this photovoltaic cell is very sensitive and not requires additional voltage. Another, it is more rugged than photoemissive cells with low cost. And along with these advantages, this photovoltaic cell has also a disadvantage, that is, it has considerable temperature coefficient and exhibits fatigue effect. Then the fifth part of the colorimeter is galvanometer. This measures photocurrents in photoelectric colorimeter. Generally, the magneto-electric type galvanometers are used. This is the simplest single cell photoelectric colorimeter by using photovoltaic cell. The constant 6 volt lamp light is used as a source. The light from the lamp is passed through the lens to give parallel beam. This is then passed through a suitable filter to give narrow wavelength range light, which is then passed through a solution solvent in a cuvette. The photovoltaic cell receives the transmitted light by the solution solvent and produces deflection in the connected galvanometer. The galvanometer reading determines the response of photovoltaic cell. Like colorimeter, spectrophotometer is also have two types: single and double beam spectrophotometer. This is the single beam spectrophotometer. It is based on the measurement of the relative light intensity before and after passing a test solution. The light source is usually a deuterium lamp for UV radiations and a tungsten lamp for visible radiations. The lamp are automatically swapped between the UV and visible region. Either prism or grating is used as a monochromator to get single wavelength light. The most commonly used detectors in single detector instrument are photodiodes or phototubes or photomultiplier tube. The events of single beam spectrophotometer are summarized here. The light from the source is passed through the monochromator like prism, which is diffracted into spectrum of light, which consists isolated single wavelength radiations. Now the selected radiation is then passed through the sample and the reference solutions. The photodetectors then receives the transmitted light and produces electric current. Electronic circuits converts the relative currents into linear transmission percentage and or absorbance. To determine the unknown concentration of solution, a series of known concentration solutions, that is standard solutions of the same analyte, is prepared by using the same solvent used to prepare unknown concentration of analyte. Absorbance readings are taken for each solution by using solvent as a reference solution at selected wavelength. The absorbance values are now plotted against the concentration to obtain the absorbance concentration calibration curve. By using the value of absorbance of unknown solution, its concentration is directly read from the calibration curve. Colorimeter and spectrophotometer are advantageous due to its high sensitivity, that is, it determines very small amounts of the sample, and another, it takes much less time than the classical methods. Along with quantitative analysis of colored solutions, colorimetry and spectrophotometry is used to elucidate formulae and stability constants of the colored complexes. It is also used to determine pK values of the indicators, and it can be used to determine the structure of organic and inorganic compounds.